Welcome, everybody. You're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science, and today we will be sending data from Python to MySQL. As always, the code will be linked in the description below. The purpose and outcome today will be to make a connection from Python to MySQL, send a CSV file as well as a data frame to MySQL, then from MySQL, dump a table as a CSV file. Lastly, show a few useful commands. You need to import mysql.connector, pandas, and CSV. If you have user credentials, you need to import those as well and the function that's storing them. If you're interested in creating a config file, just look at the link above. If you are not in a position needing user credentials, just use this similar formatting and see if that works for you. I am calling my user credentials, which are key value pairs, establishing a connection, creating a cursor, allowing me to query and send or retrieve data. The file we're using today, which would be fake sales data, consists of three columns: credit card, CPU, and purchase date. We need to create a table where we say, the table will be CPU purchases, which are credit card, CPU, and purchase date for our columns. The credit card and CPU are varchar, whereas the purchase date is a date. Okay. Then make sure everything is fine and dandy. Perfect. I need to mention something with these two blocks of code. The first thing is that this is relevant if you are sending files to MySQL. You can get into a position where there are security settings that do not let you send a file. And if you're calling like a load function with local, for instance, this is relevant. You need to change the setting to 1, and then you look and make sure that it executed, and you say show global variable like local file, and it should print on. This, pardon me, is for if you get a situation that you cannot export a file, such as a CSV from MySQL, and where you see this empty string, you'll see a null, and we'll take care of that. I changed mine already, so I'm able to export files. Let's get into creating our CSV, basically dumping the CSV to MySQL. Okay, so what we need to do is use the with open. This is one method that I chose to do, and call the file name, which would be CPU purchase, and then alias that, and I'll just call it C, where I'm creating a variable named reader, taking the CSV reader from our file with a delimiter of commas, and then create a data list from the reader, and I'll print that out. And here it is, but we need to get rid of this if we're about to send our data. So we'll just take that. Perfect. So let's get into using the cursor. We're going to use execute many because we're sending more than one object to MySQL. And we need to use a insert statement here. So we're saying insert into our table, which is CPU purchase, what columns? We're calling the credit card, the CPU, and the purchase date. Okay. Then we need to say let's call values. And this is going to look similar to the string operator of Python, but it's not exactly the same. And then we need to call our data. Then when you call our data, we send it off, and we just sent 5826 rows. We can make sure everything looks good, just for sanity's sake. Now we can send our data frame. So I call this CPU sales, where I say pd.read CSV, and then I call the file that we're working with, and then we basically can take this whole thing again and just change one piece here, where we're taking our pandas data frame and we're saying CPU sales, but we only want the values. And then that should be right. Let's find out. CPU sales. Yep. Now we just doubled everything because we appended to the end, just for proof of concept, but you can remove duplicates. Now, on to where the hurdle begins. When you're exporting a file from MySQL, you have security settings that are kind of like, they kind of want to avoid having hiccups. So you have something like this come up, a secure file priv, and you're like, what is going on with this, right? And so when I try to send the file, I kept getting an error. So let me show you for timing. This is the error that you get right here. It says the server is running with the secure file priv options, so it cannot execute the statement. And you say, oh man, this sucks. So then what you do is you run this command, which says show variables like secure file priv. And this is what you'll end up getting as a null. That's what you need to change. After the fact, you see it becomes an empty string like this, and that's what you want. So what you need to do is you create a file. I use Vim. I'm in a Mac. But you use this little twirly looking thing, and you make this file. And inside of it, you just use this. You cut and paste this, basically. This is on Medium. I found that the guy's name was Andrew Pong CO, I guess. And you paste this in, you save this file. Then what you need to do is you need to basically exit an instance of MySQL, and then you need to stop the server and then restart the server. And then that should have you good to go. And then what you do is create the out file that you want to send off. So then you could export files now. So you do out file equals, and then we're going to do a select statement and say select all from our CPU purchase table into out file. And then you use the little twirly looking thing, and then where you want it to go. I'm going to throw it on my desktop in a folder called MySQL Python with a file name. This is the file you want to call it, CPU, and then out file sales.csv. And that's what I'm calling it. And then to send this off, you use the cursor again. Now it just sent off. And then we go in here and we see that we just created the file. And here it is. Then I was able to basically print off. I just limit it. print off to make sure our data is still preserved. And then the basic commands that I wanted to show you is you could say, well, who are all the users that are available? So you say select user from mysql.user. You print that off, and that's all my users. You could also look for all the databases. You could find out what current database you're at or using, which is select database and then the parentheses. And then you can show all the tables that are available. Now, I would like to say thank you for watching. I hope this brought utility to somebody. Please subscribe, and if you do, turn on that notification bell. Throw a like if you thought this was useful, please. If not, leave a comment and tell me why so I can make this channel better for all of us. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.